Hello YouTube friends, Dr. Teresa here. Not too long ago, someone asked me how to tell if their dwarf seahorse was pregnant, so I thought I would do a video on it. First of all, if you didn't know, it is the male of the species who gets pregnant and not the female and the male that you will see giving birth. In this video, you can see towards the top a pair of dwarfs rising, and the seahorse on the right extends a tube down into the pouch of the seahorse on the left, and you see that pouch just fill up. It's hard to tell here, but it will turn a bright red. Now you may be thinking a tube entering an opening sounds a lot like a male entering into a female. I can understand how that could be confusing. But that tube is actually an ovipositor tube, and the female pushes eggs down through that tube into the male's pouch, and in the pouch is sperm that fertilizes the eggs once the eggs enter and are sealed in. Now in this video, the female is on the left, and I don't believe these two were successful in transferring eggs, but you can see the tip of the female trying to reach into the pouch of the male. Next, you'll want to be able to see the difference between a male and female. So in this video, the female is on the right, and you'll notice that her abdomen or belly, it goes directly into her tail, almost forming like the letter D. The male is on the left, and notice that his belly tapers more into the tail, and there he has a pouch that is not inflated. Here's a nice view of a female. You can see very clearly that her abdomen goes directly into her tail. And here's another nice looking female. Again, this one's very clear. The abdomen, it forms a curve going directly into the tail. And here's a male with a healthy pouch, and you can see that the bottom of his abdomen slowly tapers down into his tail. Although it doesn't take long to figure out which of your seahorses are males and which are females, the flirting behavior of dwarf seahorses, and actually of all seahorses, involves the male pumping his pouch full of water, and it expands very large, and so new seahorse keepers think maybe their male is pregnant when they see that big pouch. But if you look very carefully, the pouch looks almost transparent, and of course there's an opening there and you can't see any eggs. So the male is definitely not pregnant in these cases. By contrast, a pregnant seahorse's belly will look more solid, definitely full, and if they had eggs deposited in the last previous 12 hours, the belly might even have a pinkish tint to it because the eggs inside that are red are showing through to a degree, and they look sort of pinkish through the skin of the male's pouch. Now, not all seahorses are this big. This guy probably had at least a dozen that he gave birth to, but there are other different degrees of pregnancy, more or less. And this male, his belly is a little smaller than the one that we're just looking at, but it's pretty clear that he's pregnant, and he's been pregnant for a little while. There's no pinkish coming through in his belly, and my guess is he was probably carrying about 8 to 10 babies, which is still a good amount. But there are seahorses who have way less than that. For example, this male, he definitely has a belly that's bigger than just when it's normally lying flat, so my guess is he might be having around 46 babies. And the same thing with this male. He'll probably just have a couple of babies, which isn't that unusual. Of course, the most exciting part is when the pregnant papa gives birth. And you'll see here it looks almost like a mass of string, and those are babies intertwined with each other, but they'll eventually separate and then start swimming around. I hope you found this video helpful. I've been receiving lots of comments lately from people telling me how much they're appreciating the videos. I really appreciate those comments, so thank you very much for sharing. It's good to know that I am providing information that some people like or even find useful. If you have a question about dwarf seahorses or would like more information about some of the videos that I do talk about, please feel free to reach out, leave a comment. I'd love to make a video about it. As always, I appreciate you and thank you so much for watching.